Kathy. How are you? Kathy, we got some girls here from Ithaca College.
So you're doing a documentary on flea markets.
Right. Well, I think we're going to stick now with, we looked all up, because we're kind of in the off season, you know.
No!
So we looked up, this is about four that we found, but we decided we were sticking with Chemung.
Do you know where the fuck you are? You and me,
Chemung!
Baby! Wake up!
Do you have any comments on the customers?
No.
Dope.
Take the fifth.
Oh, gosh.
Stop. Time to break it down.
This is Wilton Tift. He is the founder and owner of the Chemung Flea Market, but he's really a photographer. He makes fun of fine art photography and calls it shit. He makes fun of many other things, including us. What's he call you, Meg?
Squeaky.
And likes to make fun of our questions and our style of filming. He never reveals any information to us regarding customers or other employees. He just hints. So we think that he thinks many of the customers are weird.
This man is Denny Durr. He is probably the most successful vendor at Chemung with his NASCAR collectibles. Anything a customer wants, he can get. His pride and joy is that he is the biggest distributor of touch lamps in the Northern Tier. He takes his job very seriously, which includes Dennis, his 14-year-old son, who is the touch lamp technician. Denny takes his job past the weekend and into the week. Chemung is his second home.
Welcome to the jungle. Got money games. Got everything you want.
Who wants that?
We know the names. We are the people that can find whatever you may need.
This is Marty. That says it all. When you need something, you call on Marty. She likes to shop more than sell. We couldn't interview her very often because she forgot a vital part of her anatomy. Her teeth. But we love Marty because she forces the other vendors to partake in interviews with us. She has a hearty laugh and is easy to get along with. Everyone knows and loves Marty. She is the heart of Chemung.
I don't know.
I'm gonna get some clothes.
No, I don't.
Want you flee. Welcome to the jungle. Take it day by day. If you want it, you're gonna bleed. My bounty price is paying you. Very sexy girl.
His name is Gary Norman. We know that he works for Will, but they don't have parties together because Jen asked.
Thanks, Meghan.
He is quiet while reading his vampire books and looking at his magic cards, which coincidentally he bought from Denny. He is a voyeur, hoping to meet his true love while selling the most interesting thing in the flea market, the square egg cutter.
Alice Weston. Alice collects wades. And if you don't know what wades are, then join the club, because we don't either. But she really wanted to show us her collection of wades, so she gave us her bank deposit slip. Alice talked about wades for 2 hours in 20-degree weather, but thinking about those wades kept her warm.
Yeah, this is Indian guy. No, but really, his real name is Andy Warhol. You thought he was dead? No, this is Andy Warhol, the one and only Andy Warhol. He owns a dank motel and collects Indian anything to decorate it. He likes to give us goofy looks and show us his tires. Welcome to the jungle.
Squeaky.
Okay.
I haven't got my teeth in.
See you next week.
Okay.
We'll be
back.
Bye bye.
Anything else you'd like to comment about on the flea market?
Nothing. Go right off hand.
No. It's interesting.
I don't know.
Oh, no.
You know, I don't know these people as much as they don't know me.